Hello student, this is Latif sir. Today I am going to start a new chapter of class 8 chemistry, the chapter 4. The topic is atomic structure. In this chapter you have to learn about Dalton's atomic theory, discharge tube fundamentals or subatomic particles of atom, atomic models, atomic number, atomic mass, isotopes, atomic mass, electronic configuration, valency, molecule and chemical bond. Okay, this is the syllabus of this chapter. So let's start the chapter 4 of ICSE class 8 chemistry. Topic is atomic structure. We have already know that everything around us is matter, and matter is composed of small or tiny particles known as atoms and molecules. First you have to read about the historical background of atoms and molecules. Around 600 BCE, Maharishi Kanad, a great Indian philosopher, originated the idea that the smallest particle of matter is called paramanu. The smallest particle of matter is called paramanu, which is in modern terms, which is called atom. Okay, and paramanu is indestructible and eternal particle of matter, and these particles are so minute that they are invisible to the unaided eyes. A paramanu does not exist in free state. It combines with other paramanus to form bigger and more stable particles, which are called anu, which is in modern terms, which is called molecule. That is, anu means molecules, and paramanu means in modern term, which is atom. Okay, paramanu of same substances combine with each other to produce dianuka. That is diatomic molecule. You have already studied in previous chapters. That is diatomic molecule. And if a molecule contains three paramanu, then it is called trianuka or diatomic molecule. Kanada also put forward the idea of paramanus combining to produce chemical changes in the presence of heat. He gave blackening of earthen pot and ripening of fruit as example of this phenomenon. Later, between 460 to 370 BCE, the Greek philosopher Democritus named the smallest individual particle of matter, as atom. Originating from the Greek word atoms, meaning indivisible. The atom means in Greek. A Greek word atoms meaning indivisible. According to the theory of Democritus, atoms are always in motion and they are indestructible. And now modern theory, atomic theory of Dalton, that is Dalton's atomic theory. In 1808, John Dalton, an English chemist, proposed the atomic theory, and the main points of Dalton atomic theory are as follows. Dalton told that All matter is made up of very minute and electrically neutral particles, which are called atoms. Dalton told that all matter is made up of very minute and electrically neutral particles, which are called atoms. And atoms are indivisible and can neither be created nor destroyed. According to Dalton, atoms are indivisible and can neither be created nor destroyed. And he told that all atoms of an element are identical in mass and properties. All atoms of an element are identical in mass and properties. The atoms of one element are different from the atoms of other elements. And the atoms are the smallest unit of matter that take part in chemical reaction. You have to remember, and in previous chapter I have already told this one, that atoms are the smallest unit of matter that take part in chemical reaction. The atoms of an element combine with the atoms of another element in a fixed ratio to form molecule of compounds. Atoms of an element combine with atoms of another element in a fixed ratio to form molecules of compound. The number and the type of atoms in a given compound are always fixed. The number and type of atoms in a given compound are always fixed. When the atoms combine, they do so in simple numerical ratio. For example, in water, in H2SO4, in HCl, the ratio of number of hydrogen atoms to that of the other atoms is 2:1 in H2O. In H2O, the ratio of hydrogen, number of hydrogen atom to the number of oxygen atom is 2:1. In H2SO4, the ratio of the different atoms present in H2SO4, is 2:1:4. That is 2 hydrogen atom, 1 sulfur atom and 4 oxygen atom. That's why the ratio is 2:1:4. And in HCl, the ratio of hydrogen atom to chlorine atom is 1:1. Okay. And these are the postulates or main points of Dalton atomic theory. Now, discharge tube. What is discharge tube? It is an electronic appliance or electrical instrument and is consists of a long glass tube. A discharge tube consists of a long glass tube closed at both ends. You can see in the figure 4.1, this figure shows that this is a discharge tube which is made up of long glass tube and both the ends are closed. It has two metal plates A and B. You can see in the figure. Okay. Two plate A and B. One is called cathode, another is called anode. And both the plate are made up of metals. Plate A is attached to the negative terminal of a high voltage source and act as cathode. The plate A, you can see the plate A at the left side of the discharge tube, and plate B at the right side of the discharge tube. And plate A act as cathode, and plate B, which is attached to the positive terminal of high voltage source, and act as anode. A vacuum is created in the glass tube with the help of vacuum pump. This is the entire discharge tube. Now, When a high voltage of about 10,000 volt, both the electrode, that is cathode and anodes, are connected through a high voltage source, high voltage generator. And when a high voltage of about 10,000 volt is applied across the plate A and B, along with a very low pressure inside the discharge tube, approximately the pressure is approximately 0.001 millimeter Hg pressure, while the atmospheric pressure is 1 millimeter Hg pressure. Hg pressure, but inside the atmospheric pressure is 760 millimeter Hg pressure. Okay, but the pressure inside the discharge tube, the gas pressure inside the discharge tube, is very low, and it is nearly about 0.001 millimeter of Hg pressure. Just think that atmospheric pressure is 760 millimeter Hg pressure, while inside the discharge tube the pressure is very low, 0.001 millimeter Hg pressure. Okay, so when high voltage, nearly about 10,000 volt, applied across the two plate, cathode and anode, what you will see? You will see that the portion of the tube behind the plate B, the portion of the tube behind the plate B glows with a greenish yellow light. This is the observation of this cathode, of this discharge tube experiment. You will see a greenish yellow light just behind the plate B, that is just behind the anode. Okay, you can see in the figure 4.1, it is written in the right side of the discharge tube, greenish yellow glow. This glow is caused by invisible rays that emerge from the cathode under the given conditions. That is, when you applied a high voltage, that is nearly about 10,000 voltage, you will see invisible rays originating from the cathode and moving towards the anode. And these rays are therefore called cathode rays, because these rays are originated from cathode and moving towards anode. And when these cathode rays strike the glass just behind the plate B, that is anode, you will see a greenish yellow light. So during the late 19th and early 20th century, many scientists were researching to establish the nature of these cathode rays. Two notable experiments and observations are given below. First experiment, this is associated with this discharge tube experiment. Okay, so when an object kept in the path of cathode rays cast a shadow, you will see a shadow just behind the object, in the opposite side of the cathode. When you kept an object in the path of cathode rays, cast a shadow. Okay, you can see in the figure 4.2, cathode ray cast a shadow of object. Here it is object also given. Okay, and from this point it is clear that cathode rays travel in a straight line. Cathode rays, from this point it is clear that cathode rays travels in a straight line. That's why you get the shadow of the object present in between the cathode rays and the opposite side of the discharge tube. Okay, so one conclusion is cathode rays travel in a straight line from the cathode ray discharge tube. Okay, now second point, if a paddle wheel kept in the path of the cathode rays, the cathode rays start rotating. From this observation, it is clear that you can conclude that the cathode rays consist of a stream of fast moving small tiny particles, because particles can rotate a paddle wheel. Okay, so from this point, that is, if a tiny or light paddle wheel kept in the path of cathode rays, the paddle start rotating, and from this point we can conclude that cathode rays consist of a stream of fast moving particles. Okay, so two observations of cathode ray experiment. One is cathode rays travel in a straight line, and cathode rays consist of a stream of fast moving particles. Okay, you can see in the figure 4.3, cathode rays can rotate a paddle wheel. Okay, so now fundamental or subatomic particles of atom. Subatomic or fundamental particles of atom means particles which present always present in an atom. You know about proton, neutron and electrons. These are the fundamental or subatomic particles of atom, because atoms is constituted by these particle. Okay, so fundamental properties, fundamental particles of an atom. The studied and the discoveries during this period really revealed that atoms are invisible, and they are composed of smaller particles. The three main particles present in an atom are electrons, protons and neutrons, and these particles are known as fundamental or subatomic particles. Okay, I have told that proton, neutrons and electrons are subatomic particles, because these particles are always present in an atom. Okay, next I'll discuss about the discovery of electrons, proton, neutron. Okay, thank you.